Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'll be talking about the Figma plugins that make my life easier. Let's get started.
Okay, I look like a proper YouTuber with this one. I'm not used to it, I'll do my best. First plugin I want to show you is called Similayer. In my company, I'm working a lot on design system projects and I'm working a lot on components. So this plugin is really handy for me, especially when I need to make changes for a group of variants or instances. So let's say this group in the middle, we are gonna change this disabled state to its focus state, just let's say. And then first thing you need to do is find that instance you need to change. Here, what I need to change is multi-select input. As you see, here it's disabled. So we'll select all of these and I'll press Command P and then open Similayer. And I usually search layer name. So this brings all the layers in this selection. So let's see how can, okay, here, multi-select input. So let's click this one and select layers. As you can see, we selected all of them and with one click, you can turn this off and then make it focus. Ta-da! It's really handy. Tell me if you're already using this or how can I use it some other way. This is one that I really, really like. Let's say your client sent you these text groups. You need to split them into different text boxes so you can style them, you can use inside other layout. What we need to do is to stop working with that client. Joking, we just need to use this plugin maybe. I'll do Command P and open Nisa text and UI. I like the UI. We want them to split from here into different text boxes and we want to remove this dot thingies. Okay, so here just paste it and bam, you see it is like magic. And it says page, page, page. We don't want the page. Maybe here we need a space as well. So for this one, I'll show you another plugin, but let's use it here as well. Command P, find and replace. So this is basically, you can find and replace the word or like something inside a text box. This is so handy when a specific word or a like a name of the feature changes, so you can basically select all of the frames and then bam, like change all of it at once. Let's do it. Space page and then replace it with nothing. It already found six of them, just these ones, and bam, gone. And let's do this again. I just want to split them, but and then I also want them inside of an auto layout. So split oil layout and bam, you see, perfect, love it. Use it and let me know if you like it. Okay, Stark, maybe you already know this. This is an accessibility tool that you can use for many things, but one thing I like using it for to check the contrast ratio with text and the background or icon on top of the background. So let's try Stark contrast. Basically just select the text. If your text is bold, 14 and above is considered as large text. If it's regular or like not bold at all, then it should be above 18 to be considered as large text. So in this case, this doesn't really look like a large text to me, but yeah, it already passes normal and large as well. So for accessibility reasons, you should aim to pass at least AA. If you are interested in this, I'm sure the blog of Stark has a lot of information related to this. Let's check this one as well. This also passes. You see this gray text looks really minimalistic and calm in a way, but this is actually not really readable. In many cases, maybe this is not accessible for everyone. Maybe for some, but not everyone. We are good with this. This is the Stark one. This is called master. I was using this before, but now since we have variants and stuff, not sure if it's really handy anymore for me, but I still want to show it because when I first started using this, it was like magic. It can be useful for you. This is not a free plugin actually, but you must have a trial version. You can check that out, and if you want, you can buy it, expense it. What this plugin does. Let's say you're working on a design and you don't really know which frames will be duplicated, and you just don't create it as a component, and then you end up with all of those duplicates. So this plugin can be handy for you if you want to select all of those duplicated frames and create one main component out of them. So what we can do is we can click and then we can press enter, and then we can press enter again, and it will select all the child elements. We should be mindful that this is different than the others because it has this small text description maybe and a check mark. So this is also different. You need to eliminate the different ones and the others can stay the same. And then you'll press Command P and then search master, create component from objects. Then you see we have a component and these all duplicated stuff is connected to this thingy. Let's make one from this one with the tick, create component, and then this one, create component. And what we can do is right now you can select all of these and say combine as variants. The property can be like, let's say selected, and we can say false, and these are false and this is true. We can make this like help text, or let's write it better, make developers happy. And this should be true because we have two true ones and one false. False. Let's play with this. Help text. Oh, it changes text and stuff. Selected. So you can basically just change for all of them. And then you can make sure that these all have the same fill. And this is also like already same. And then now when you change them, they are not gonna change anymore. If you need to do, like, you can update only the ones that are necessary here. If this is confusing, let me know. I can maybe create a video on variants, components, all of that stuff as well. I was planning on creating a master Figma course once, like especially focused on components, variants, like Boolean operations and like all of this stuff that you see here, but I didn't. Let's do this one as well. As you can see, these three are the same. Let's pick them. Create component from objects. Perfect. Raw. Let's do this one as well. Oh, I forgot to activate my license. I already have it, but sometimes it just says that you need to activate, but I already did. I don't want to do this. I don't have time for activating a license. You get the idea. Ultra Renamer. Let's say you're creating a presentation. These are all the weird named artboards you have. Should I say frame? When I say artboard, I feel nostalgic and remember sketch.
Hello darkness, my old friend.
Let's say you have all these frames. They are not really renamed in a good way. You have all the copies. And even sometimes, like while you're working, you selected these two and you mold them like this. So it's like, it's a mess. And let's say you use rename selection and you say, I want to rename it like number. Delete N, by the way, it deletes the zero thingy. And rename. As you see, it's still a mess. What we will do is we'll use Ultra Renamer 2 going bam this way. Okay. Rename. This is perfect. Just use this if you are working on a presentation. Imagine these are not really 14 and you are working on like 50 something. Really, really easy. Let's go to find and replace. I already mentioned this one, but I want to just do it again because why not? Let's say you worked on this, you finished it, you're calm, you're delivered, you did your handoff and all of your stuff, and your PM said, we'll change it this to view documentation instead of view more. What you need to do is like changing this one by one, and imagine having a lot of frames. What you can do is kill the PM or use this plugin. So let's say you have so many frames in this page. If you open up that find and replace plugin, it will be stuck and it will like froze to death. So make sure you move them to another page. The only frames that you need, move them. And then let's open it. Command P, find and replace. It's better if you don't write them, because when you start writing, it starts searching. Imagine it tries to search all the letters you're writing. It's gonna go crazy. So just copy and paste it. And it says font 4 and make this view documentation replace, and all done. We did it. Cool. Let's do one more. Start with an example. Replace all. Yay. That's all. Too much reflection. That's it, actually. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to give thumbs up and subscribe my channel. I do travel, vlog, illustration videos, basically whatever I like. I think this was also fun. I'm planning to do more product design videos. If you like this, please share your comments, thoughts, feedbacks, anything. It means a lot for me, or would encourage me to do more. So just do that, please. And yeah, see you in the next video. Bye-bye.